tono te awe te nei hoki tō koutou pōpakan nui ana I te mātauranga haere mai haere mai whakatau mai ira.
Please be seated. Enga mana, enga reo, enga hoa e whā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, University staff, special guests, graduands, whānau and supporters. As Chancellor of the University of Auckland, I extend a warm welcome to you all on behalf of Council members and staff of the University. This is a meeting of the Council of the University of Auckland at which the Pro-Chancellor and I will confer diplomas and award degrees in the Faculty of Engineering. Graduation is a time for celebrating success. Today, you will experience the pomp and tradition of this ancient ceremony and the recognition befitting your success on your well-deserved day of celebration. Like your family and friends gathered here, we're very proud of all your achievements and look forward to your lifelong involvement as members of the University of Auckland family. Of course, graduation represents more than just a day of celebration. Your qualification from this university will have a lifetime impact on you, your family, and the community at large. We know that compared to those whose formal education ends in high school, graduates have lower unemployment rates, higher salaries, better career prospects, and better health outcomes. Universities New Zealand has estimated that the lifetime benefits of a degree are valued at between $1 million and $4 million a year. Your university experience and the qualifications gained at university will thus add real value to your lives and to the lives of those around you. The fact that our university can add value in these ways reflects the abilities and achievements of our staff and students. In the Faculty of Engineering, we've seen several notable achievements in the last year. Professor Margaret Hyland was awarded the Royal Society of New Zealand Pickering Medal for her pioneering work into the reduction of fluoride emissions produced by aluminium smelters. Dr. Michelle Dickinson received the Callaghan Medal for her work raising public awareness of the value of science in New Zealand. Professor Nicholas Smith and Professor Grant Kovic were elected fellows of the Royal Society of New Zealand. And Dr. Penn Du was awarded a Rutherford Discovery Fellowship. In order to ensure that we can continue to achieve successes like these, and to enhance our contribution to future generations of graduates and to our nation, the university must do three things. First, we need to attract students of high academic potential and give them an outstanding academic and extracurricular experience. In this respect, I believe we're doing very well. The proportion of domestic students entering the university with a high grade point average is growing each year, and we produce outstanding graduates just like you. Second, we need to attract, develop, and retain outstanding staff. This we are doing as illustrated by the achievements I've just described. Many of our staff are world leaders in their fields, and you will have been privileged to learn from and work with them. It's no coincidence that in the QS World Rankings of University Subjects, The University of Auckland came top in New Zealand in 35 of the 40 ranked topics. We don't even teach two of them. So if we think about that result for a moment, there are 40 ranked subjects. We teach 38 and we came top in 35. It sounds like an outstanding result to me. Thank you. And third, we need to create the kind of academic environment and facilities that support and encourage excellence. To this end, the university has been investing heavily in its campus renewal program to ensure that we do provide facilities of genuine international quality. Many of you will graduate today with the first qualification, and you will be rightly proud of this achievement. However, I also want you to reflect on the ongoing learning opportunities and the wide range of postgraduate options available to you at this university. You must never rest on your laurels in a challenging and ever-changing world, but rather be prepared to embrace change and new technology and make the most of the opportunities presented to you. Although it may seem a daunting prospect right now, further study and learning is inevitable for us all as the world changes around us at an ever-accelerating pace. So whatever path you follow, I urge you, as the alumni of New Zealand's leading university, to never forget your alma mater, your university. We rely on our graduates for support, moral, political, and financial. But today is your day, with the focus firmly on your achievement. At this ceremony, we honour your success, along with the support of your family, whānau, and others who have sustained you through your studies. I congratulate you and trust that you will long cherish the memories of your graduation today. I am pleased to welcome our speaker, Ian McRae, an alumnus of this university holding a Master's in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Engineering with Honours. Ian is the founder of Orion Health, which, under his stewardship, has seen unprecedented growth and success. It has grown from a small company with just four staff in 1993 to a global healthcare platform with more than 1,250 staff in 27 international offices and customers in more than 30 countries. Last year, Orion Health listed on both the New Zealand and Australian stock exchanges and as an NZX 50 company. Ian received a World Class New Zealander Award in 2010, and Orion Health became the only company to win the Supreme High-Tech Company of the Year for the second time in 2014. Before founding Orion Health, Ian was a senior telecommunications consultant for Clearfield Consulting. He's also worked for Ernst & Young, designing corporate networks, as a product manager at Imagineering Micro Distributors in New Zealand, and as a senior business analyst for the London Stock Exchange. Please join me in welcoming Ian.
Thank you. Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the Council, members of the university, graduates, families and friends, I'm honoured to be with you to celebrate today's graduation from engineering schools of engineering school students from the University of Auckland, one of the finest universities in the world. And I say this not because of the number of published research papers, I'm sure there are many, but because of the innovative and entrepreneurial spirit that we observe in Auckland graduates that we hire at Orion Health, actually, and in particular the engineers. Okay, yeah. And here I could be accused of being a little biased. I was indeed an engineering science graduate, actually from a bygone era, possibly a less enlightened era. Actually, hippies were still cool when I graduated. Jimi Hendrix was almost, actually, he was still alive. Young woman did not actually study engineering back then. And there was events such as the university pub crawl, the Engineers Haka Party in Smoko. In fact, I'm pretty sure some of your lecturers behind me today will remember those events. Anyhow, many long-haired graduates from my generation have gone on to great things, particularly in business in New Zealand and internationally. You may conclude this was a result of an inspired curriculum. However, for me, and I suspect for others, this was not completely the case. While I learned a huge amount at Auckland, I've sadly forgotten much of this over the last 35 years. When I reread my master's thesis, I struggled to get past the first page of partial differential equations. Actually, there were quite a few of them there, by the way. It was a really difficult page to read. So some might conclude that Auckland's attempt to educate me was something of a failure. However, such an assumption would be wrong. This leads me to the first of 3 points I would like to make today. At the University of Auckland, I learned how to learn. And learning for me has been a lifelong journey. Today I'm the CEO of probably New Zealand's largest software company. No tertiary qualification could have taught me even a small percentage of the knowledge I have needed for my job today, and I continue to learn. My thesis topic was creep buckling in Antarctic ice shelves. Yep, it was a great topic. And I left Auckland knowing all about the mechanical properties of ice. It served me well, okay? Since then, I've become an expert in data analysis, networking, leadership, software development, the health sector, being a listed company that's living the dream, and many other areas. More recently, I've had to learn a lot about the human genome, single nucleotide polymorphisms, copy number variants. I've had my genome partially analyzed. I've realized I don't process ibuprofen, but I'm good for chemotherapy. That's something to look forward to. And I have the positivity gene. One does actually exist. It means you're more positive and you can handle stress. So it goes. So out of necessity, I had to continually learn. And the ability to continually learn separates good leaders from bad, those with self-awareness and those without, and those who are defeated by life and those that conquer everything before them. As Henry Ford said, anyone who stops learning is old, whether you're 20 or 80. Now, something that Auckland failed to teach me was what I could not do. And this is my second point. I have never learned what I could not do. And this is a peculiar New Zealand trait, I believe, that I see daily in our young people. They just don't seem to realise that they can't climb Mount Everest or fly the first plane or win the America's Cup. Actually, we didn't quite do that, but we'll do it next time. Explore the far reaches of the world or become the head of the United Nations. And at Orion, we compete against companies such as multinationals such as IBM or Microsoft or other global giants for national health projects and win. We're up against some very, very big organisations. This belief that we can do anything is a wonderful gift that our country must never lose. But there are some things that are truly very hard. For me, spelling has always been a bit of a mystery. My dear late aunt, who was a fine primary school teacher, after an entire summer holidays of effort, concluded that I would never, ever be able to spell anything more than my name. Which leads me to my third point. I have learnt you can do anything if you really, really want to. All that usually holds us back is desire, or that we haven't used our imagination to figure out how to do it when the obvious solutions are impossible. I am pleased to say that I've overcome my relatively mild spelling limitations, and not by working my way through the Oxford English Dictionary, but by developing what we would call in the software industry workarounds. This is when your software application doesn't quite work, it has the odd bug or two that you can't fix or don't want to fix, so you tell the customer another way of solving their problem, a way of working around the problem. So today I have developed some very effective spelling workarounds. Firstly, scrawly handwriting. Actually, this is very appropriate for engineers. When I studied, they used to have a T-shirt we used to have, once I couldn't spell engineer, now I are one. So but that was back in my day, okay? So I find scrawly handwriting is just fantastic. It camouflages, I don't have a clue how to spell this word. Then there is Microsoft Word, which is truly a dyslexic's best friend. And finally, I've hired some people who are truly really good at spelling. Today, I am fine at spelling, as George Bush would say, mission accomplished. Now, at Orion, through single-minded determination and plenty of workarounds, the main thing we had to work around was never having enough money. We have built a global software company headquartered in New Zealand. Most experts would say that this wasn't really possible and that moving to the United States was essential for company growth. They were wrong, and today we have caught up and passed most of our historic international competitors. We have done this by continuing to learn. Today we're here to celebrate your academic achievements, of which you should be very proud. The University of Auckland has taught you how to learn, and I urge you to make learning a lifelong passion. You may forget partial differential equations, but you must never forget how to learn. Nothing is impossible. We are usually only held back by self-belief, desire, or imagination. So thank you for listening to me, and do enjoy today.
Thank you, Ian, for a most insightful and challenging speech. Please join with me in thanking Ian once more. This is a meeting of Council and Convocation of the University, at which the Pro-Chancellor, Scott St. John, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of the ceremony.
By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Scott St. John, Pro-Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who within the Faculty of Engineering have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Deputy Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, Professor Highland, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Deputy Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Engineering. Graduate Diploma in Engineering, Heroi Tsagaya Estefanos. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering with Second Class Honours, Second Division. Catherine Jane Galan Herrera. Devendra Lutchman. Young Xuan Wong. Yuang Zhu. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering, Jasmine Ojula Sundu. Kashyap Ramas Chavan. Sam David Granger. Samuel Henry Luke Hood. Anuj Kumar. Simon Robert Layton. Chan Kun Lee. George Shu Chi Lin. Ji Hao Lin. Jared Blair Mason. Kavan Kumar Masuria. Haveya Fanahia Pamaka. Maria Bernadette Josephine Robertson. Najibula Wakili. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honors with First Class Honors. Senior Scholar Engineering, Thomas Elliott Adams in Engineering Science. Vyacheslav Alexandrov in Mechanical Engineering. Connor Brent Anderson in Mechanical Engineering. Logan Ross Andrew in Mechatronics Engineering. Haley Aaron Anir in Civil Engineering. Narendra Linus Araldson in Engineering Science. Jonathan Nicholas Bacon in Chemical Materials Engineering. Colin Edward Baggett in Mechanical Engineering. Tristan John Baum in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Elise Anna Beavis in Engineering Science. Shivani Vanessa Bevan in Software Engineering. Abigail Jane Birkenhall in Mechatronics Engineering. Robert Denis Georges Boucher in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Matthew Aaron Bradley in Mechanical Engineering. Renee Ann Brockie in Chemical Materials Engineering. David Alexander Brown in Mechatronics Engineering. Sophie May Burridge in Civil Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Andrew Peter Kondiki Carroll in Mechatronics Engineering. Mark Peter Casey in Civil Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Jiachu Chen in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Melody Young Chen in Biomedical Engineering. Ying Chen in Engineering Science. Chern Chi Chuk in Mechanical Engineering. Mike Ming Chi in Chemical Materials Engineering. Henry David Chittuk in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Senan Nuo Koloko in Computer Systems Engineering. Jason Grant Coventry in Civil Engineering. Dylan John Crichton in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Daniel Jedediah Svetanich in Civil Engineering. Abdelhamid Yusuf Ahmed Dabour in Mechanical Engineering. Joshua Ross Alexander Dawes in Engineering Science. Liam John Doerr in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Blair Richard Eastwood in Mechatronics Engineering. Candice Martine Eckert in Computer Systems Engineering. Matthew John Jarvis Evans in Mechatronics Engineering. Jared Kane Evanson in Civil Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Nicholas Clark Graham Finch in Mechatronics Engineering. Jenna Lauren Finlayson in Software Engineering. Jonathan Allen Freeman in Civil Engineering. Frances Claire Fulton in Mechanical Engineering. Vicky Dan Gao in Mechatronics Engineering. Simon Peter Gasson in Mechanical Engineering. Sarah Helena Gorman in Mechanical Engineering. Daniel Anthony Guinto in Chemical Materials Engineering. Yan Jin He in Computer Systems Engineering. Danya Harat in Biomedical Engineering. Jeremy Westerby Hitchings in Chemical Materials Engineering. Samuel Tiam Chin Ho in Civil Engineering. Ho Wan Ri in Chemical Materials Engineering. Sung Hyung Hong in Chemical Materials Engineering. Rachel Daniel Houston in Civil Engineering. Yi Yang Huang in Software Engineering. Yi Lin Huang in Mechatronics Engineering. Kristen Leanne Hurley in Civil Engineering. Tasneef Tahid Hussein in Software Engineering. Stefan Paul Husak in Civil Engineering. Ha Ram Huang in Mechanical Engineering. Jessica Margaret Jacks in Civil Engineering. Mohammed Ayman Bin Jamsari in Mechanical Engineering. Joanna Allison Jarvie in Civil Engineering. Vinura Ramal Jainati in Mechatronics Engineering. Ashley Thomas Jones in Civil Engineering. Nikita Cabra in Software Engineering. Sahil Kalani in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Gaurav Rajesh Khara in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Akshay Pravan Kalyan in Software Engineering. Liam George Kempshoff in Biomedical Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Michael George Captain in Engineering Science. Chloe Alexander Karyanis in Civil Engineering. Jesslyn Kaur in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Rahul Amrit Kaushik in Chemical Materials Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Nicholas John Kay in Mechanical Engineering. George Theodore Lamb in Mechanical Engineering. Edward Jonathan Lawley in Mechanical Engineering. Ji Ron Lee in Mechanical Engineering. Matthew Kevin Leah in Chemical Materials Engineering. Andrew Thomas John Lees in Computer Systems Engineering. Jen Yi Lim in Chemical Materials Engineering. Dominic Dao Ming Lin in Chemical Materials Engineering. Oliver Daniel Lin in Biomedical Engineering. Tobias Peter Looker in Mechatronics Engineering. Yi Chen Liu in Engineering Science. Jonathan Tyler Luton in Engineering Science. Oliver Thomas Lum in Civil Engineering. Alexander James Luttrell in Chemical Materials Engineering. Sarah Jane Matzig in Civil Engineering. Akshat Malhotra in Mechanical Engineering. Sivasegaran Manoharan in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Andrew Paul Robert Marriott in Chemical Materials Engineering. Caleb Arapeta Matheson Dunning in Civil Engineering. Penelope Jane Maxwell in Engineering Science. Morgan Tipa McCauley in Mechatronics Engineering. Connor James McCowan in Mechatronics Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Amanda Pamela McLaren in Civil Engineering. J. Alexander Davis Mills in Mechatronics Engineering. Siti Nadija Muhammad Razali in Chemical Materials Engineering. Peter Moore in Mechanical Engineering. D. Mu in Mechanical Engineering. James Alexander Monroe in Civil Engineering. Rion Naidu in Software Engineering. Edwin Harry Nixon in Civil Engineering. Sarah Alice Langer Novus in Civil Engineering. Louis Turia Olsen Stahl in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Aaron Han Park in Engineering Science. Jun Young Richard Park in Chemical Materials Engineering. Jamie David Peterson in Software Engineering. Vincent Jing Wei Pua in Civil Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Michael Philip Prendergast in Engineering Science. Ella Rose Priest Forsyth in Engineering Science. Jonathan Robert Prinz in Mechanical Engineering. Anna Chen in Biomedical Engineering. Hao Young Chu in Civil Engineering. Pushpaka Anjana Rabol in Civil Engineering. Vaspan Siris Raimawala in Computer Systems Engineering. Ravan Ram in Chemical Materials Engineering. Hayden William Randalls in Engineering Science. Michael Edward Rasmussen in Mechatronics Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Stephanie Mary Cheryl Rucastle in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Katie Michelle Richter in Civil Engineering. Harrison Whitaker Faulkner Roberts in Civil Engineering. Carl Paulus Rupa Fantafort in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Sarah Elizabeth Riddell in Chemical Materials Engineering. Neural Heiser Sapier in Chemical Materials Engineering. Connor Chuan Le Siu in Chemical Materials Engineering. Augustus Peter Shade in Mechatronics Engineering. Jatinder Pal Singh in Mechatronics Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Michael Nelson Sinner in Mechanical Engineering. Briarly Rose Smith in Mechatronics Engineering. Frank Richard Smith in Civil Engineering. Abdul Moiz Syed in Chemical Materials Engineering. Cameron Caponado Tauranga in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Benjamin Hewitt Taylor in Chemical Materials Engineering. Maxim Darius Turani Rad in Mechanical Engineering. Nigel Trinidad in Mechanical Engineering. Samuel Jacob van der Saar in Mechanical Engineering. Samuel Robert van Oostrom in Mechanical Engineering. Sailesh Vempati in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Nikhil Rohan Vishwanath in Chemical Materials Engineering. Anmol Wadhwa in Software Engineering. Alec Mingren Wong in Biomedical Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Li Jen Wong in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Wenwei Wong in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Mark Alexander Watkin in Software Engineering. Nicholas Allen Weatherburn in Software Engineering. Xiao Su Wen in Chemical Materials Engineering. Jacob Roy Whitford in Chemical Materials Engineering. Wilson Wijaya in Mechanical Engineering. Rick Shane Wilkinson in Civil Engineering. Kale Sterling Dennis Wright Wood in Civil Engineering. Sarah Frances Woodward in Civil Engineering. Hayden Derwent Wright in Civil Engineering. Senior Scholar Engineering, Hao Young Su in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. David Yan in Computer Systems Engineering. Hao Bo Yu in Engineering Science. Ashin Zaman in Civil Engineering. Feng Ji Zhang in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Zhou Hao Zheng in Mechanical Engineering. Wei Yin Zhou in Chemical Materials Engineering. Andrew Ju Ge in Computer Systems Engineering. Sasha Christopher Zollner in Mechanical Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honors with Second Class Honors, First Division. Tijal Acharya in Civil Engineering. Jonathan Charles Addison in Civil Engineering. Matan Arohan in Civil Engineering. Millie Grace Alexander in Civil Engineering. Jacob John Allen in Civil Engineering. Mark Akram Badi Aziz in Software Engineering. Lawrence Kevin Tapuro Baldick in Software Engineering. Jia Ban in Civil Engineering. Jonathan Richard Beardmore in Mechatronics Engineering. Emily Shu Lee Bennett in Engineering Science. Akshay Vashishta Bhatt in Civil Engineering. Merlin B.G. Machu in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Andrew Jeffrey Bolin in Biomedical Engineering. Thomas Fraser Boyens in Biomedical Engineering. Samuel Arthur Brady in Civil Engineering. Angus John Brankley in Mechanical Engineering. Eva Brocious in Civil Engineering. Keegan Samian James Brown in Mechatronics Engineering. Takashi Daniel Burden in Civil Engineering. John Robert Burrows in Software Engineering. Sunil Chapagai in Mechanical Engineering. Helen Yanan Chen in Chemical Materials Engineering. Jeremy Michael Choate in Civil Engineering. Harry George Clay in Civil Engineering. Oliver Jack Conaglan in Civil Engineering. Simon James Cox in Civil Engineering. Ellie Dominique Benicek Kraft in Civil Engineering. Gregor Ian Cunningham in Chemical Materials Engineering. Samuel James Cousine in Mechanical Engineering. Rowan St. Gregory Sashika Da Costa in Civil Engineering. Lono Jean San Jose de Jesus in Civil Engineering. Daniel Henry Sebastian Delmel in Mechatronics Engineering. Yan Wen Deng in Mechatronics Engineering. Richard Lloyd Dyer in Civil Engineering. Abdul Wahib Hassan Hosni El Karmani in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Aaron Neville Falconer in Civil Engineering. Samuel Timothy Field in Mechanical Engineering. Robin Diana Finley in Civil Engineering. Zane Dylan Gibbs in Computer Systems Engineering. Juha Kamal Goswami in Software Engineering. Christopher Mark Gray in Mechatronics Engineering. James Robert Jeremy Greenfield in Mechanical Engineering. Yue Han in Mechatronics Engineering. Storm Miriam Harpam in Mechatronics Engineering. Paul Christopher Hazard in Mechanical Engineering. Felix Conrad Herling in Mechanical Engineering. Jason Peter Hodgson in Civil Engineering. Peter Hong in Mechanical Engineering. Ho Jia Yong in Mechanical Engineering. Zheng Yi Hu in Software Engineering. Xu Chen Huang in Mechatronics Engineering. Toby Edward Jackson in Biomedical Engineering. Samuel Philip Kelsey in Civil Engineering. Asul Khan in Computer Systems Engineering. Fraser Jackson Killip in Computer Systems Engineering. Hiro Kono in Civil Engineering. Nitya Kalyani Lakshmanan in Biomedical Engineering. Johan Tsung Hong Lo in Civil Engineering. Samuel Peter Law in Civil Engineering. Amanda Michelle Lee in Civil Engineering. Chen Young Lee in Software Engineering. Jackson Peter P. Lester in Civil Engineering. Ji Liao in Civil Engineering. Di Cheng Liu in Civil Engineering. Michael Thomas Lowe in Software Engineering. Harry George Lovelock in Civil Engineering. Julia Jane Loverich in Civil Engineering. Rick Ewan Lowe in Civil Engineering. Melissa Hui Li Lu in Civil Engineering. Joshua Matthew Philip Mapstone in Computer Systems Engineering. Nathan James Martin in Computer Systems Engineering. Toby James Bernard Martin in Chemical Materials Engineering. Sarah Jane McCullum in Civil Engineering. Cameron James McKee in Civil Engineering. Michael Robert John McKnight in Computer Systems Engineering. Sean Raymond Nash McNichol in Mechatronics Engineering. Benjamin Mark McPherson in Civil Engineering. Muhammad Sufyan Ahmed Mita in Software Engineering. Tanwir John Muhammad in Civil Engineering. Nipuna Kularatne Mohotigi in Civil Engineering. Faris Izzuddin bin Nafaya in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Anna Rose Northey in Mechanical Engineering. Ogun Sargun Odisho in software engineering. Richard Daniel Panara in mechanical engineering. Kyle Gregory Peace in chemical materials engineering. Darshan Pradhan in civil engineering. Timothy John Prestige in mechatronics engineering. Soham Girish Rege in civil engineering. Richard Chun Yen Si, nope. Lucy Anna Ruck in mechatronics engineering. Richard Chung Yen Si in computer systems engineering. Mayank Sharma in electrical and electronic engineering. Harry James Stoke Shepherd in civil engineering. Sashin Sindraj in civil engineering. Carlson Man Lam's Hugh in electrical and electronic engineering. Diwaka Somu in computer systems engineering. Brendan Farjet Song in civil engineering. Brendan Mark Speakman in engineering science. Daniel Westbrook Squires in civil engineering. William Herbert Sturm in mechanical engineering. Shan Su in engineering science. Ji Young Sun in chemical materials engineering. Jen Wang Tung in mechatronics engineering. Yu Shen Tei in civil engineering. Liam Dean Thompson in chemical materials engineering. Joshua Paul Thompson in civil engineering. Lincoln Hapita Timoteo in civil engineering. Matthew James Trengrove in engineering science. Matthew John Van Oosterhout in civil engineering. Ji Sheng Wang in civil engineering. Rebecca Kate Ward in mechanical engineering. Thomas Oliver Ward in mechanical engineering. Jack Rohan Whitfield in chemical materials engineering. Anna Rose Whitmore in chemical materials engineering. Joshua Bennett Wilson in civil engineering. Samuel Roland Wilson in civil engineering. Michelle Esther Windsor in biomedical engineering. Andrew Thomas Wong in Mechatronics Engineering. Warren Paul Roth in Civil Engineering. Feng Fei Ya Su in Civil Engineering. Tian Yi Yu Bo Shu in Mechatronics Engineering. Xiao Qian Yang in Civil Engineering. Ji Bo Yang in Civil Engineering. Wen Long Yuan in Civil Engineering. Xin Yuan Zheng in Civil Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honors with Second Class Honors, Second Division. Ahmad Hadi Abu Ghazala in Civil Engineering. Bin Yang Bai in Civil Engineering. Gregory Thomas Baker in Civil Engineering. Nathaniel Brett Bierman in Mechanical Engineering.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of this ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Natasha Wilson and Kayla Collingwood will now perform the Flower Duet by Leo Delib.
Thank you.
Thank you, Natasha and Kayla, for that wonderful performance. Ladies and gentlemen, please join with me once again in thanking Natasha and Kayla. If you would like to hear more from our wonderful young musicians, I invite you to attend the graduation concerto gala competition to be held in the town hall on Thursday, 12th of May at 7:30 p.m. Admission is free. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Engineering, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering, Professor Smith, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Kate Helen Boyan in Mechanical Engineering. Michael Alexander Brown in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Alexander Daniel Cashin in Mechatronics Engineering. Pang Su Chang in Mechatronics Engineering. Jonathan Elliott Thomas Chaplow in Mechatronics Engineering. George Chen in Civil Engineering. Royce Allen Chin in Civil Engineering. Gregory Lewis Clements in Civil Engineering. Kong Ding in Civil Engineering. Ian Drayton in Mechanical Engineering. Malcolm John Finch in Mechanical Engineering. Reuben John Finch in Mechatronics Engineering. Jeffrey Roland John Gibson in Civil Engineering. Olivia Michael Gill in Civil Engineering. Yinan Gao in Civil Engineering. Dalton Mark Harris in Civil Engineering. Roderick Hadiwibo Wo in Civil Engineering. James Christopher Hand in Mechatronics Engineering. Muhammad Alif Fitri Hanipa in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Elisa Retinta Hadi Yantu in Civil Engineering. Apple Harris in Civil Engineering. Karen Roderick Barr Hill in Mechanical Engineering. Isaac Nihana Patrick Johannes Howard in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Daniel Ng in Mechatronics Engineering. Nina Jane Ives in Engineering Science. David Yixing Zhang in Civil Engineering. Bahuvathi Katha Gamanathan in Engineering Science. Sarah Louise Ningharaka Kelly in Civil Engineering. Song Yang Ku in Civil Engineering. Nathan Alex Knight in Mechanical Engineering. Nathaniel John Lama in Civil Engineering. James Fergus Alfred Lawrenson in Civil Engineering. Lanling Lee in Civil Engineering. Sue Lee in Civil Engineering. Callum James Lifting in Civil Engineering. Eric Lin in Computer Systems Engineering. Nicholas Lombard in Mechanical Engineering. Hantao Liu in Civil Engineering. Shenghao Liu in Software Engineering. Nico David Lumanglas in Mechatronics Engineering. Kurt Robert McAlpine in Software Engineering. Jared Ethan McCulloch in Civil Engineering. Samantha Alice McGuire in Civil Engineering. Thomas Allen McKee in Civil Engineering. Stefan Costa Masilovic in Civil Engineering. Akash Nanda in Civil Engineering. Joshua Chalapan Nari in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Simon Thomas Wupura Nathan in Civil Engineering. Abhijit Parak in Civil Engineering. Owen Glenn Payne in Civil Engineering. Stephen Trevor Ridgway in Mechanical Engineering. Thomas Porteous Rowe in Civil Engineering. Sveta Baljit Sanju in Electronic and Electrical Engineering. Zachary John Schuster in Civil Engineering. Bernadette Aninga Amy Swalja in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Sarah Allen Scott in Civil Engineering. Ola Shahin in Engineering Science. Ji Yu Shi in Civil Engineering. Tai Tia Ariki Tia Nako Stevens in Civil Engineering. Lauren Kirsten Stuckley in Civil Engineering. Wei Chang Su in Civil Engineering. Nicholas George Sullivan in Mechanical Engineering. Nathan Craig Summerscales in Civil Engineering. Min Cheng Tang in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Ru Yang Tan in Mechanical Engineering. Papua Barona Tamati in Civil Engineering. Simon Melville Franklin Thomas in Biomedical Engineering. Hayley Ann Tregoeth in Civil Engineering. Tributa Alat in Civil Engineering. Isabella Maria Rawinia Vermont in Civil Engineering. John Zemon Valoria in Computer Systems Engineering. Dina Wallace Michelle Vincent Taparu in Civil Engineering. Minora Rothage Vinathaj in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Tisong Wang in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Lumen Wang in Software Engineering. Pasa Ingi Savinja Rikrarama Rachi in Mechatronics Engineering. Mika Jesberg Wild in Civil Engineering. Ping Yang in Civil Engineering. David Shane Yi in Civil Engineering. Benji Zhao in Civil Engineering. Alice I. Mi Zhuang in Civil Engineering. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours conjoint with First Class Honours, Sarah Jane Bild in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sam Malcolm Caldwell in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hanlan Chen in Software Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. Sarah Howden Daniel in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. Senior Scholar Science, Mikhail Dennis D'Souza, Software Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. Senior Scholar Business and Economics, Donovan Dutoit in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Luke Joseph Harries in Computer Systems Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Shi Yang in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Andy Peter Honne, Captain in Mechatronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sophie Evelyn Kincaid in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Commerce. Danny Kim Ho Kwok in Electrical and Electronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Chen Yi Liao in Electrical and Electronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Arts. Harrison Dexter Hardcourt Luz in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Matthew Michael Marinovich in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Arts and Senior Scholar Engineering, Matthew James Victor Milner in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Arts. Brett Alexander Skeets in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sean Kenneth Sito in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Science. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, Katrina Smirnova in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar, Business and Economics, and Senior Scholar Engineering, Samuel Yunho Wong in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Senior Scholar, Engineering, and Senior Scholar Science, Yujia Chi in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. Henry Hao Nang Wang in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours, conjoint with Second Class Honours, First Division, Zhuiwen An in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Vishal Prakash Bula in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Brooke Gregory Dyer in Computer Systems Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Benjamin James Goodger in Engineering Science and a Bachelor of Commerce. Swapnil Karnak in Computer Systems Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Raghav Krishna Krithaventi in Civil Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Priya Unjali Mittal in Electrical and Electronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Science. Junyoung Park in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sanjayan Dayan Surendran in Biomedical Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Alda Janet Van in Mechatronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mickey Suen Wen Yang in Mechanical Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Engineering Honours Conjoint with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Nicholas Ryan Merrington in Electrical and Electronics Engineering and a Bachelor of Arts. At Yantika, Tede Makti in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Master of Energy with First Class Honours, Nasser Usman Faruqi. Robbie Hermawan. To the degree of Master of Energy with Second Class Honours, First Division, Chi Sung Fan. Craig Warwick Peter Soul. To the degree of Master of Engineering with First Class Honours, Min Chung in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Ryman Hassam in Mechanical Engineering. Kerry Jean King in Civil Engineering. Jamie Jose Detalo Kinau in Engineering Science. Leela Sadeghi in Environmental Engineering. Pao Ting Tu in Chemical and Materials Engineering and a Bachelor of Engineering Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Yanfrey Wang in Mechanical Engineering. Lawrence Hao Run Wong in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Sashan Zhang in Environmental Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering, Hans Raj Bajwaj in Software Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering Management with First Class Honours, Amanda Marie Petey. Yu Fang Chow. To the degree of Master of Engineering Management with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Vikashan Gunaratnam. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies with First Class Honours, Osama Mahadid S. Al Alossi in Construction Management. Benjamin Mark Conway in Yacht Engineering and a Graduate Diploma in Engineering. Jose David Delgado Mosquera in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Khan He in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. James Alexander Hope in Medical Devices and Technologies. Sophia Adele Johnson in Medical Devices and Technologies. James Man Hin Lee in Software Engineering. Pranav Melu in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Hayo Jun Park in Civil Engineering. Melwin Francis Batera in Software Engineering. Paul Andrew Rasmussen in Construction Management. Gagandeep Singh in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Harman Singh in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Walter Jayant Silvapala Surendram in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Isa Schwinn in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Zhengquan Si in Environmental Engineering. Siohe Zhang in Software Engineering. Jayo Dani in Civil Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Azam Al-Tahafi in Construction Management. Avizek Chandra in Mechanical Engineering. Samit Keshav Chanani in Construction Management. Tanuja Hands in Software Engineering. Haiwen Thi Than Nu in Construction Management. Tazni Mool Islam in Civil Engineering. Jatin Katara. Sahand Tharaka Lapi Wickrama in Transportation. Bowen Lee in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Kong Lee in Civil Engineering. Li Li in Software Engineering. Wei Lui in Civil Engineering. Cole Ryan Mehring in Construction Management. Junji Pan in Software Engineering. Ayapa Pulyanda Thimaya in Mechanical Engineering. Jeju Shi in Medical Devices and Technologies. Yu Yi Song in Software Engineering. Kong Wu in Civil Engineering. Sing Hu in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Siming Yan in Software Engineering. Jishuang Yang in Food Process Engineering. Boxin Zhang in Civil Engineering. Sheng Zhang in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Venkata Nagarohit Ganturi in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Swinivasa Krishanan Halakari Janadhana in Civil Engineering. Priyanki Patel in Transportation. Gujaman Gopal Prabha in Mechanical Engineering. Chaitra Prakash in Chemical Materials Engineering. Bin Shi in Mechanical Engineering. Vignesh Srinivasan in Civil Engineering. Wei Sun in Environmental Engineering. Marin Tomazdik in Construction Management. Jen Quin Jang in Software Engineering. Jin Jang in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. To the degree of Master of Engineering Studies, Jemmy Sharon Arumaraj in Mechanical Engineering. Yi Quin Gao in Software Engineering. Patrick John Gorringe in Medical Devices and Technologies. Dibyana Rayan Hazra in Mechanical Engineering. Eugene Lee in Medical Devices and Technologies. Bo Wang. Yui Wang in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. To the degree of Master of Operations Research with First Class Honours, Neil Morris.
I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Masood Ali Poor in Bioengineering. Masood investigated the fibre structure of muscles in the lower limb of both a rabbit and human using novel diffusion tensor imaging and 3D ultrasound techniques. He then evaluated the influence of fibre structure on muscle mechanics and how this could be used to inform muscle appearance in the animation industry. Masood. Nalshad Ali Nasim bin Amir Ali in Civil Engineering. Nasim studied legislation in 14 jurisdictions and found that introducing adjudication led to significant savings in time and cost when resolving construction disputes. He recommended legislation on adjudication be written in modern plain language to make it even more effective. His work was presented to the New Zealand Parliamentary Select Committee when the Construction Contracts Act was being amended, and formed the basis of recommendations to the Malaysian government, resulting in the Construction Industry Payment and Adjudication Act of 2012. Mardila Awalini in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Adela investigated a novel method to improve the corrosion resistance of magnesium to allow it to be used as a biodegradable osteoimplant material. She used a specially designed calcium phosphate-based bioceramic coating, which which extended the lifetime of the material when tested in a simulated body fluid. Adela. Reza Barzin in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Reza looked at the application of phase change materials, or PCM, in buildings in combination with a price-based control method for peak load shifting applications. He used PCM wallboards, PCM underfloor heating systems, night ventilation and weather forecasting to minimise the heating and cooling cost in residential buildings while performing a successful peak load shifting. Hoi G. Bay in Electrical and Electronic Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Hoi G. developed a fleet charging system for electric bicycles that enables simple, efficient and effective wireless recharging in public areas. This system helps to decrease concerns over battery capacity and range due to its ease of use and promotes the use of electrical bicycles in dense urban environments where traffic congestion and greenhouse emissions are a real concern. Hoi G. Grant Dennis Burke in Mechanical Engineering. Grant investigated combining residential gas water heaters with those using other energy sources. Novel appliance designs, control systems, test and modelling methods were developed to improve the energy efficiency, running costs, and carbon dioxide emissions of water heating systems. Right. Ronald Pingman Chan in Mechatronics Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Ronald investigated the impact of friction on balancing two-wheeled robots on low-traction surfaces. Limits in ground traction affected a two-wheeled robot's ability to balance. By modelling these limits as additional constraints, he developed an extension to a model predictive controller, an advanced method of control based on looking ahead to find an optimal control strategy. Liang Chen in Electrical and Electronic Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Liang focused on the management of power distribution in wireless power transfer applications with multiple independent loads to smooth out the total power requirements and avoid transient peaks that may cause a shutdown. The work ensures the reliability of supply while enabling lower cost designs to be realised that are competitive in cost with wired systems. As a consequence, new applications in both materials handling and roadway powered electric vehicles are now more attractive economically. Yeah. Yu Chen in Mechanical Engineering. Yu Chen studied the effect of using hydrogen as a supplementary fuel in internal combustion engines and its effect on engine knock. He also studied the effect of using hydrogen as a supplement at engine idle operation in order to improve idle performance. Specifically, this had the effect of reducing engine roughness. His findings may have important automotive applications. Yu Chen. Therese Marie Clark in Bioengineering. Therese developed a method to obtain temperature and flow measurement from a miniature implantable pressure sensor. The multimodal sensor has applications in the management of patients with brain injuries. From short-term monitoring of traumatic brain injuries in the intensive care unit to long-term implantation for monitoring of hydrocephalus. This has the potential to allow timely diagnosis, targeted treatments, and improved outcomes for patients. Nigel Gordon Cleland in Chemical and Materials Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Nigel looked at how the design of the New Zealand electricity market influenced the behaviour of large industrial consumers and electricity companies. This work showed that when limited reserve generation is available, the secondary reliability market can drive electricity prices higher. Samuel Michael Collinson, an Electrical and Electronic Engineering University Doctoral Scholar. Sam investigated the use of field programmable gate arrays to accelerate ray tracing, the computationally intensive process used to create the highly realistic images required for motion pictures. He proposed a flexible platform that increases productivity for future research and shows greater bandwidth and power efficiency than the commonly used graphics card and processor. Sam. Matthew Richard Cutfield in civil engineering. Matt investigated probabilistic methods of assessing the earthquake performance of buildings and applied them in order to better understand the costs and benefits of adopting base isolation to provide earthquake protection in new buildings. Yeah. Duncan Thomas Eason in Electrical and Electronic Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Hyperspectral imaging captures information about a scene that humans cannot see, but the extra data necessitates compression. In special circumstances, this compression can be done during acquisition. This is called compressed sensing, and Duncan developed a series of methods that reconstruct the original scene from the compressed samples. Soror Gazioff in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Soror used a newly developed method called sol-enhanced electroplating to produce zinc-nickel nanocomposite coatings with significantly improved wear and corrosion properties. These coatings can be used widely as an alternative for the toxic cadmium coatings in automobile and fastener industries. Emily Joyce Hargrave Thomas in Chemical and Materials Engineering. Emily showed that the degeneration in the joints of dairy cattle is a valid model for early osteoarthritis in humans. By characterising the structure and mechanical properties from the macro to the nanoscales throughout the degeneration of cartilage and bone, she provided new insight into the mechanical factors for the initiation and progression of osteoarthritis. Prem Kumar Naik Kethavath in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. Prem investigated reduction of electrical power system inertia due to increasing penetration of renewable generation like wind farms. Transient instability, a potential cause for large electricity blackouts, is strongly dependent on available system inertia. His work developed energy function methods to quantify the inertia required to maintain stability and innovative control methods that can be applied to electricity networks globally. Sushil Katiwada in Civil Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Sushil investigated the force transferred when neighbouring buildings collide during earthquakes. Such collisions are called building pounding and have caused significant damage to the buildings in past earthquakes, including the 2011 Canterbury earthquake, but there is no reliable formula to calculate the forces involved. Based on his numerical and experimental tests, Sushil proposed a new expression to calculate pounding forces, which can lead to the design of better retrofitting measures. Sushil. Sung Soo Kaur in Civil Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Sung Soo developed a mathematical modelling framework for regional resource flows and transformations to estimate the optimal growth level and limits to growth. The framework opened up a way to look at the concept of carrying capacity of the environment and of human infrastructure systems using industry efficiency data. Sung Soo. Wei-Yuen Liu in Civil Engineering. Wei developed an advanced energy-absorbing device and design procedure to allow multi-storey timber buildings to be built in seismically active locations. Charles Zhe Liu in Mechanical Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Charles investigated how iterative learning algorithms can be applied to rehabilitation robots for treatment of stroke and sport injuries. He developed and validated a method to automatically optimise the robot control systems. This technique may improve the effectiveness and accessibility of robotic therapy, which can provide tangible benefits to both patients and physiotherapists. Xiaobo Liu in Bioengineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Xiaobo studied the underlying physics of human speech production by modelling the anatomy and dynamics of articulatory physiology, the fluid dynamics of airflow during speech, and the acoustics of the consequent sound generation. The mathematical models were derived from patient-specific multimodal data exhibiting the structure and motion of the human vocal tract during speech, and are capable of simulating flow-induced speech sounds. Xiaobo. Nurul Zuhaira Mahmoud Zuhudi in Mechanical Engineering. Nurul Zuhudi successfully developed a hybrid material consisting of a bamboo fabric polypropylene composite sandwiched between glass fibre polypropylene composite sheets. The hybrid material exhibited better flammability and durability properties than those of the constituent composites. Siamak Moradi in Engineering Science. Siamak contributed to the field of network flow optimization by developing and analyzing algorithms for solving the bi-objective multi-commodity minimum cost flow problem. He was the first to develop column generation theory for this bi-objective approach. A practical application of his research was the estimation of the value of time in traffic models based on observed network flows. Congratulations. Ganesh Ramanan Nagendra in Electrical and Electronic Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Ganesh designed electronic systems that could be incorporated into highways that help provide wireless power to moving vehicles. Such highways would allow electric vehicles to drive significant distances along motorways at speeds over 100 kilometres an hour without depleting the charge in the onboard battery. This dynamic power transfer will also help reduce the overall cost of electric vehicles in the future. Ganesh. Heejong Park in Electrical and Electronic Engineering. The size of embedded applications is growing significantly each year. With increased time to market pressure, automatic and verified code generation from a system-level design language is becoming of the utmost importance. To accelerate the design process of safety-critical software systems, Heejong developed new methods for correct by construction specification design and incorporated formal verification methods for programs described in globally asynchronous, locally synchronous formal models of computation. Heejong. Olga Paradirieva in Engineering Science. In her thesis, Olga focused on an application of network equilibrium models called traffic assignment. These models allow researchers to analyse traffic flows on road networks, to predict the impact of projects, and to control traffic with respect to level of congestion, emissions, and toll revenue. Olga studied theoretical properties of this problem and proposed various algorithms for solving it. Olga, congratulations. Anthony Edward Phillips in Operations Research, University Doctoral Scholar. Anthony studied the complex scheduling and staffing problems which arise in academic course timetabling. Developing new algorithms based on integer programming, he demonstrated the capability to outperform existing heuristic approaches. These methods can improve the utilisation of university resources from a human and economic perspective. Anthony. Mohammed Poshtar in Civil Engineering. Mohammed developed a novel multi-objective optimization scheduling method to reduce the negative impacts of variability on construction projects using time buffers. He proposed a calculation framework using applied statistical inference and probability theory that provides the optimum location and size of buffers in construction schedules. A computer prototype was developed to ease the use of the method on site in projects. Samantha Alda Rodriguez in Chemical and Materials Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Disc herniation is a common spinal condition that frequently involves failure of the intervertebral disc at its attachment to the vertebrae. But what causes this junction to break and how does it break? Samantha's research studied the structure and failure mechanism of this junction, providing insights into its remarkable architecture and strength. Sophia Areta Rodriguez in Chemical and Materials Engineering, University Doctoral Scholar. Sophia's thesis focused on understanding how food breakdown during chewing relates to perceived texture in solid foods. Her research analysed the factors that dominate texture in biscuits, cheese, and chocolate. It was part of the New Zealand Food Structure Platform program, which aim to gain fundamental knowledge that will allow food structures to be designed to enhance sensory appeal. Sophia. Shamia Sata in Bioengineering. Shamia developed an efficient computational environment for investigating gastroelectrophysiology. His thesis presented a cell model capable of accurately representing external pacing. This was incorporated into tissue-based and organ-based models, able to determine the effects of tissue microstructure and external pacing on the propagation of the underlying electrical activity. His thesis will advance gastric pacing strategies and aid in the development of next generation gastric pacemakers. Jimmy. Darshini Srinivasan in bioengineering. Darshini developed a novel computational framework to evaluate anabolic bone treatments validated using a 3D printed bone technique. She then tested her model as part of a human clinical trial and two mouse studies and successfully predicted the outcomes of the experiments. Her model can play a role in informing future clinical evaluation of bone treatments. Si Leng Tay in chemical and materials engineering. Si Leng's research aimed to study and develop novel coating systems with two insoluble metals using the ionic co-discharge method. Bismuth was co-deposited with different metals, including nickel, silver, zinc, and copper. The mechanical properties of these coatings were significantly improved without losing other desired properties. Kimberly Morgan Twigden in civil engineering, university doctoral scholar. Kimberly's research advanced the current state of knowledge of unbonded post-tension concrete walls for use in seismic regions. Emphasis was placed on systematically investigating both the static and dynamic experimental response of such wall systems. Using the experimental data generated, simple numerical modelling techniques were investigated, and the direct displacement-based design process for these systems was verified. Sarad Amanath Venugopalan in electrical and electronic engineering. Sarad examined integer linear programming and tree heuristic algorithms, looking at how each approach may be used to optimally schedule tasks onto parallel processes. The proposed formulation and algorithms showed significant speed improvements in finding such schedules and demonstrated that the best way to go about solving the problem involved using a suite of applied mathematical techniques. Jindy Young in chemical and materials engineering. Jindy's thesis focused on modifying nitinol surfaces using electrochemical etching and anodization techniques. Her thesis demonstrated that these techniques are effective approaches to enhancing the biocompatibility of nitinol surfaces. The modified nitinol surface was tested for surface roughness, wettability, toxic nickel ion release and cell material interaction, and has potential applications in biomedical areas. Jindy. Eugene Kinchi Yip in electrical and electronic engineering, university doctoral scholar. Nowadays, multi-core processors are used in many safety-critical applications, from automotive to medical devices, where timing glitches can lead to harm. Eugene addressed some of the fundamental difficulties with multi-core programming and associated safety by designing a new parallel programming language, a precise timing analyzer, and a novel scheduling approach that allows safety-critical and non-critical software to coexist within one system. Eugene. Ashley Kendall Young in chemical and materials engineering, university doctoral scholar. Ashley investigated how food properties change during chewing from first bite to swallow. She related the texture perceived by consumers to flow properties and structure of chewed biscuits. Her research contributes to a greater understanding of food oral processing, which will enable the design of specialised foods, for example, healthier foods that do not compromise texture or taste. Ashley. Ting Yu in electrical and electronic engineering. Reconfigurable hardware shows great potential for accelerating large-scale biomedical simulations. However, the complex technology is not widely used by biomedical scientists due to the lack of hardware expertise. Ting Yu investigated the automatic generation of hardware accelerators from a high-level description of biomedical models. She proposed a hardware accelerator with a software-hardware co-design system and developed related optimization strategies. Adil Zahir in electrical and electronic engineering. Adil worked on a new magnetic pad design that can be used to charge electric vehicles without any physical contact. This not only allows the battery of parked vehicles to be charged, but can also be used to transfer power to a vehicle on the move. He demonstrated that this new design is interoperable with the already proposed designs and usually outperforms existing pads proposed for roadway power while being lighter and cheaper. Qian Zhang in chemical and materials engineering. Qian developed three series of iron-based metallic biodegradable materials alloys using a simple but effective powder metallurgical method. The degradation behaviour, mechanical properties, and biocompatibility of the iron-based biometallic alloys were investigated. This showed that the developed alloys are cell compatible and meet degradation and mechanical strength requirements for load-bearing applications. Chan, congratulations. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the official record qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma in the Faculty of Engineering.
We are nearing the end of this graduation ceremony. On behalf of the university, I invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And while you are standing, it would be a good opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieve their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of council in convocation of the university for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori, then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of the program.